It is the second time in a short while that I've been here at Portsmouth with you. And JJ, the United Workers' Party candidate for this constituency, and his local team have been here with you constantly, ladies and gentlemen, interacting with you, hearing from you, listening to you, learning from you, and educating themselves on what it is Portsmouth is about, what it is Portsmouth wants to have happen to Portsmouth, learning together. Team Dominica, United Workers Party, have developed a plan for this country, including Portsmouth. You know the saying, if you fail to plan, you plan to fail. There was a time when we used to hear questions asked, what is your plan? We're not hearing from you what your plan is. No, we were in fact saying what our plan was. But there are those who chose not to hear. And perhaps they were not listening to the places where we were saying it. But it seems that they have started to listen. And so we do not hear again any talk about what is your plan. Because, ladies and gentlemen, every Dominican, tout le monde Dominique, everybody will come out of Dominica, they know the plan of Team Dominica, United Workers Party. It is a holistic plan. It is a wide plan. But if you ask anybody, what is the plan of Team Dominica? What is on their mind, what is on their chest? Is what? 5,000 jobs in 3 years. No matter what they say, you will hear 5,000 jobs in 3 years. And as the very vibrant, energetic Unica just told you, you ask any member of Team Dominica to explain how we're going to achieve the 5,000 jobs in 3 years. And just like that, just like that, just like that, they can rattle it off and tell you. We ask you to challenge us. Ask any one of them. And they will be able to tell you. Ladies and gentlemen, in a nutshell, we have indicated to you, as we have done in the past, that we believe that the construction and operation of an international airport is a crucial economic infrastructure for the development of our country. We preached it for years. Labour Party Skerrington and Ian Douglas says nonsense. They ridicule it. But on the 5th of May this year, Skerrington jumped up in St. Joseph and he said, hooray! We're going to build an international airport. Hooray! We're going to ensure, and we also told you, ladies and gentlemen, about agriculture and the importance of bringing back agriculture to play a more prominent role in the economic development and job creation of this country, ladies and gentlemen. They said agriculture has been, and we should not put money in agriculture. You remember that, ladies and gentlemen? You remember that? Yes. And we said that where employment is available in this country, priority must be given to Dominicans. You remember that? The Labour Party under Skerrington and Ian Douglas developed a policy where Dominicans would get what is left over, the quass, if anything, and priority was going to anybody other than Dominicans. Skerrington jumped up at St. Joseph and he said, whip, hip, hooray, 80% of the jobs will now go to Dominicans. Skerrington jumped up at St. Joseph and he said, look, boy, this thing is hot, 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 I cannot hold it any longer. We're going to build an indoor sports stadium. But when you look at United Workers Party manifesto, you see the indoor sports stadium there. They came into office and they neglected it and they ignored it. And then hip hip hooray at St. Joe, they're going to build indoor stadium. But importantly, ladies and gentlemen, think about it, Portsmouth. having said so loudly and boldly and forcefully that they're going to build an international airport, when it came to the budget presentation that Skerry presented a few weeks ago, you heard nothing about international airport. You understand that? The man feels that Dominicans are silly, are stupid, they don't read, they don't do anything, so he can fool them. Instead of us seeing signs of him giving Dominicans priority in jobs, what he did, he went to Ostrich Place further up the road and he said, public works people, no work for you. You understand that? You don't have to have me or Team Dominica explain that to you. But now that you heard us, go back and reflect that this is a man who decided to con you, to fool you. But he also has been advised by Hartley Henry that Dominic Hartley Henry to be a gentleman, his carried political advisor. Hartley advised him on two things. Dominicans are foolish. They don't read. In Barbados, man, everybody read a newspaper, man. You see every advocate every morning. They read the newspaper, Dominica. You ain't see what they read. They don't read. That is how, you know how I can, you know why I can say that so well, my wife is Bija. But that's what he said to Skerrick, and Skerrick take it, hook, line, and sinker. And he and a number of them have concluded that Dominicans are stupid. That's what they have said, you know. And so they can do us what they want. They can just say some things and we'll take it. We do not analyze. We don't debate. We don't discuss. Skerrick says so. Ian says so. So he's so. Now Ian doesn't say anything of his own. It's what Skerrick says. Ian says. Yeah. So ladies and gentlemen, we have a plan to create 5,000 jobs in 3 years. And almost everything hinges on jobs and employment. You're getting, Skerrick has told us, if you think about what he said in his budget compared to what Lennox Linton said in his budget, Lennox Linton is 5,000 jobs in 3 years. Skerrick is wipes and pampers. It's wipes and pampers. Pampers and wipes. Wipes and pampers. Pampers and wipes. We are saying yes. We need wipes and we need pampers, but it is better for us to be able to have a job so we can earn our own money so we can buy our wipes and pampers. You agree with me? Wipes and pampers.
I know that the people of Portsmouth are people that are very, they're upfront, they're very industrious, they're very hardworking, but they've been dealt a very bad blow. Because for the past 15 years, a government that they've worked so hard to install in office, a government that they've put their trust in, have betrayed them. And if you're honest with yourself, and you look around you, you look at the state of Portsmouth, you will agree with me. You will agree with me that the Dominica Labour Party government have failed the people of Portsmouth. And because they failed you, you need to stand up as your forebears did, as they stood up for themselves and charted their course and joined the rest of Dominica on this move for change. Because change is here. An important thing is that this current government is on its way out. This current government, in the hearts and in the minds of thousands of Dominicans, have failed. And because they have failed, they've called upon Team Dominica to make that change. And that is why we're here tonight. That is why we are with you tonight to ask this very simple thing, for you to become a part of this change. When the history of Dominica is written about the brave men and women who stood up for change, we want Portsmouth to be counted in that change. And Portsmouth can only be counted in that change if you support the man JJ. A young man who at the beginning of his career had decided that he will put this aside to serve you, the people of Portsmouth. And that's what we are talking about. That's the industry. That's the what we, you know, we call, and that's what we know pots of, to offer people that will give up themselves. This is a young man that is concerned about the future and the development of this place. You know, I was speaking earlier to some people in the crowd, and one gentleman told me, and that should give you a very good understanding of where we are in Dominica. He said, you know what, yesterday, and I hope he doesn't mind me saying this, he said, yesterday, I had a business. I fried 11 whole legs and 6 wings. Said at the end of the night, I had left 6 whole legs and 2 wings. Cannot even sell 11 whole legs in Portsmouth. That is what we have today. That is what your vote for Labour has brought to you. Can you now, in good conscience, can you in good conscience say, because you've always been Labour, that you will continue to put this government there? And not only that, but this Labour Party government is not the Labour of old. You know, I had the good fortune of meeting Mike Douglas just this once. I was a student, no, I was coming from, I think, from Jamaica, and we happened to land in Antigua on the same plane, and the plane was late. And we had to overnight in Antigua, and I wasn't sure where I was going to stay. And there were about 3 of us from Dominica. And the other person said, they have somewhere to stay. And it was Mike Douglas, myself, and this other gentleman. And he said, you know, I have somewhere to stay, but it's a little rundown guest house. And Mike said, well, let's go there, man, let's go. And this man took us, along with Mike Douglas, to this little guest house we had to kind of dump to enter in, to the really rundown place. But there was a man who was selfless, a man who was humble, and a man who cared about his people. Do you believe today that your current representative would do that?
No!
Do you believe today that your current prime minister would do that?
No!
You see, we've lost our way in Dominica. We've lost our way in Dominica. You know, Dominicans were once brave and proud people. Today, as Dominicans, we're depending upon a man to give us $500 or to build us a plywood house. I mean, what is this? Dominicans used to chat their own way forward. But we've lost our way in such a way that it's very difficult for me to understand that people who once worked hard for a living can now depend on the government to give them a handout. So they now rush to Vegas on a Thursday, or rush to Roseau on a Wednesday, to stand in line for hours on end. And now they put chairs downstairs the ministry. And now they've given snacks in the ministry so that the wait can be a little easier. But that's how we've come in Dominica. And here you have a party, Team Dominica United Workers Party, that is offering a way out. That is telling you, the people of Portsmouth, who understand industry, who understand your history, you understand the hard work that it took to build this town, that we can do better. And what it is that you will go, how can you face, in fact, your family at night and say that you will continue to support this government? When you look at the young people among you, when you look at the young people who have absolutely no hope, no chance, in this country. Is that what they want for our future? And that is a simple message we have for you tonight, Dominica and Portsmouth, is that we are on the move for change, because the majority of us now understand that it's not about party. You know, I understood growing up as a child that you have allegiance to 3 things in life, to your God, to family, and what's the 3rd one? To country. Not to party. So it's okay for you to vote against a party that is not supporting you. It is not good enough. And you need to understand this, that the power is within you, that you have the authority to change this government. You have to demand better things from your government. You are the ones that put them there. They should not be taking you for granted, and that's what they've done. They have said that Portsmouth is déjà les patates, so they can continue to just depend on your vote. So election time, Ian goes elsewhere and leaves you alone. And that continues throughout. So for 15 years, look at Portsmouth. Look at, you know, I passed here in 1974 as a young child, and I remember Portsmouth. I was so excited coming from the country to see a beautiful town, and look at Portsmouth today. 14 years and counting under the Dominica Labour Party. And can you in good conscience face the children, face the young generation and say that in 2014 or 2015, you put a vote for a government that has done nothing, absolutely nothing for this town of Portsmouth. So that's what it is all about, people. I hope you understand where we're coming from.
Charles, Zika, Portsmouth proper, Glanvilla, Georgetown, Picard, good evening and welcome. I must say, it's an honor to stand here in my own constituency, feeling at home with such a large crowd. My brothers and sisters, I must tell you, the time for change is now. The time is now. I will take you a little back in history. When Dominica was first introduced to the European nation, and it began being settled by our soldiers, Portsmouth was first selected for the capital city of Dominica due to a level of short-sightedness. It was taken from us and brought to Roseau. This was one of the very first opportunities that we had to develop our constituents, to develop our Portsmouth, to develop ourselves. In the 60s, 70s, and 80s, my brothers and sisters, Dominica was under the leadership of the late Patrick John. And yet another opportunity to develop Portsmouth was there. We had the opportunity to create the north of Dominica into a free port, and that was taken away from us. It was turned down, and instead St. Martin captured that opportunity. And today, we all know the number of families that left Dominica in search of a better livelihood in St. Martin. The very opportunity of a Freeport that is creating that better livelihood for the people of Dominica. My brothers and sisters, in this modern age, it is still evident. Every possible opportunity for us to develop ourselves here in Portsmouth is being taken away from us. When the hospital was created by the same European soldiers who settled in Dominica, as time goes by, it was developed into the state of an art hospital where we had a doctor's quarter. We had a ward for children, a male's ward, a female's ward, a maternity ward. Every possible surgery could have been done here in Portsmouth. And we took it for granted. It was abandoned. That is why under the Freedom Party, that hospital was demolished. And instead of putting a hospital that is of better quality, we got a third-class health center. A third-class health center, which has been abandoned by this present administration. And that is why a French religious institution had to come in to Portsmouth and made a few donations of bed and other accessories. My brothers and sisters, the time for change is now. Because in our very eyes, on the presentation of these accessories at the hospital, the institution representative felt so much pity for us that they said they are going to adopt the clinic and make facilities available for us. And with the lack of respect, could you imagine that the Minister of Health is reminding those representatives that our main hospital is in Roseau. That is the level of respect they have for us, my brothers and sisters. I tell you, this present hospital, this present health center, is one where you cannot even find a bandage to bandage a simple cut. And everything is paracetamol. We have the nurses here that feel so much shame that they walk with paracetamol in their pocket. My brothers and sisters, when this hospital was what it used to be, we had only one ambulance, which main duty was to serve the district. Today, under the neglect of that hospital, we have that one ambulance having to travel all the way to Roseau. And it hurt me so much to see that just the other day, I had the privilege to get a ride on that hospital with one of my family members. And it's heartbreaking. My brother and sister, this ambulance is just a shell with a bed. Because while traveling there, I had to secure myself, hold the patient to assist them, to stabilize them. And with the other hand, I still had to hold the oxygen tank. Because on leaving the hospital, the only form of stabilizing the oxygen tank was to use a piece of gauze. So by the time we climbed up the Mount Espanol Hill, that oxygen tank was unstable. Now with the rough road and lack of condition in that ambulance, even the nurse before reaching Roseau was noxious. No facility whatsoever for the person assisting. And by the time we reached up to Taru, I had to stop the ambulance because the patient was falling off the bed. And so the fire officer had to come out and assist me to stabilize that patient. The very fire officers that are working tirelessly, they hold one of the most important service ministry in the Commonwealth of Dominica to safeguard ourselves, to assist in our health. We have these very officers living in some conditions. They are living and working in some absurd conditions. And that is why when now at present in the post of constituency, the fire officers are standing up for their rights. They are standing up because they have been left to live along with rats and bats and all sorts of insects. They are being victimized. They are being victimized like many of us who stand for a right. And so a lot of them, they have been transferred to other areas. My brother and sister, this is the level of disrespect they have for us. Because they are not only being disrespectful to the fire officers, but just imagine, they put a very new crew in Portsmouth. God forbid that some fire should take place in Dodan and somebody should call and say, we have an emergency in Gwawinja area. I will not be surprised if these fire officers will climb up to Bonn, up to Emmanuel Lantan's house. Because I know they know who is Emmanuel Lantan. We all know who is Emmanuel Lantan. And the rest of us will be left to perish. My brothers and sisters, these are evidence of neglect. And with Jefferson James, your man of the soil, your leader for this constituency, will join forces with Team Dominica under the visionary leadership of Lennox Linton to ensure that we have a state of the art hospital here in Portsmouth. We will bring us back to the days when all the facilities necessary for proper health care is given to us here in Portsmouth, my brothers and sisters. If we are to look into education, again, we have been neglected and left with disrespect. Because on my inaugural speech, I made mention of a branch of the State College in the North. And to my surprise, educated men and women took the time off to sit on national radio and criticize it. It was even more heartbreaking to hear very persons from the postal constituency criticizing it.
Even teachers!
Yes, indeed, even teachers. Because we fail to have the foresight to see the amount of opportunities, lifetime opportunities that lie in the construction of an arm of the State College here in Portsmouth. Not only in job creation, with the number of students walking the streets of Portsmouth, where every young entrepreneur could capitalize on that. My brothers and sisters, that will create an opportunity for our young persons who drop out from secondary school, our young adults. They will have another opportunity to serve in education, in adult education and night classes. My brothers and sisters, right now, the only government here in secondary school in Portsmouth, the Portsmouth Secondary School, is one which does not even have an auditorium. It doesn't have proper sporting facilities. It doesn't have a proper science lab, agricultural lab, sports grounds, sports office. My brothers and sisters, it's high time that we pay attention to these things. We need to have a business lab in that secondary school so that our students can be taught business skills and practice it as well. My brothers and sisters, if we go on to sports, we all know for ever so long they have been speaking about that playing field in Benjamin's Park, the lighting of that playing field. They have played with that project for ever so long, where one businessman has done millions for the materials, and right now, after placing it on the grounds of the playing field, he's telling another businessman, try to see if you can make a million now and install it. Because these are the people that associate themselves with the present Labour Party. Those that are filled with the egoist behavior, self-centeredness. It's high time we brush those things aside and examine ourselves. The time is now. My brothers and sisters, if we look at tourism, we have a present parliamentary representative who is the Minister of Tourism. He lives on our very shore. And the potential that lies within the tourism industry for us here at Portsmouth to capitalize on, we play a blind eye to it because our power play a blind eye to it. And we do not want to disappoint him, so we lie low and allow everything to happen. The time is now, brothers and sisters. Look at our waterfront. They are boasting that they removed the ships that have been there for ever so long. But who knows the amount of site monies they are collecting for that? My brothers and sisters, we have the Borough Square area. This needs to be developed as well to what it was originally stated to be, a city square. We need to develop the ports so we could have our dinghy dock right here. So those who come in on the yachts can come right into the center of the town. We need to develop the Indian River facility. Look at the amount of jobs, the amount of persons that are there waiting for the development of the Indian River facility, and yet still we pay no attention to it. My brothers and sisters, I'll tell you, in 2004, this Bay Street was resurfaced by the Labour Party. Do you know why? Because the Wasco had to repair the water lines. The water lines were in a state that it would have caused a widespread disaster, an outbreak disaster in Portsmouth. The water condition was so bad that they had to repair it. And because of that, the government had to come in and resurface this road. Today, it reoccurred again, where Harbour Lane has suffered the same. The Wasco had to come and repair the lines along Harbour Lane. And after waiting for over 2 years, it's only now on the eve of election, the government has come in to resurface it. And then we'll sit there and say, Labour Katawai Aguatas. Labour Katawai. That is what we call development. My brothers and sisters, I'll tell you. Just recently, the Prime Minister presented the national budget. And I was following it up on my telephone. And I asked myself that question. I wonder how many persons from my constituency are listening to that budget presentation. Because when the Prime Minister made that presentation, Everybody knows very well that he made a special emphasis on Pampers and Wipes. That is why they call it the Pampers and Wipes budget. But I want to draw your attention, your close attention, to one thing in particular. The Prime Minister said that the people of Silver Lake were given land at 25 cents a square foot. And other village was given land for sold land for dollar square foot. We here in Portsmouth, we are quite aware that we have three generations living in one household. Grandparents, parents, children, grandchildren, and even great-grandchildren living under one roof. We have lands at Georgetown, the famous Promise Hill. We have land at Cotton Hill. We have land at One Mile. Chance. I wonder how many of us are asking ourselves that question. I am certain that not one of us can stand up and say that we have gotten land for 25 cents a square foot. And where the opportunity lies for us to expand this town, to develop ourselves, our family, it has been taken away from us. So even the parliamentary representative will come back on his presentation of that same, at that same budget, and he'll reiterate that very phrase of the Prime Minister, that land was given for 25 cents and dollars square foot. And they will come around and send the same lying stories in different ways through different ministers that lands have been made available. I will tell you that with Jefferson James, Team Dominica, we will resolve that land issue in Dominica and make land available for you, the young people of Dominica in particular, to develop yourselves, develop your family. Because I'm certain that not one of us here, especially the older ones, can stand firm and say that today there are opportunities for young people to develop themselves and build their homes at a very early age, like we have, like you all have done. When you are about 21 years, there are a lot of persons that have already built their houses. Today, that opportunity is not evident in our daily life. Because we are there under that roof, suffering under that Labour Party.
Civil servant teachers.
My brothers and sisters, a lot of us are afraid to speak. But I'm telling you, the time is now. The time to speak is now. Because there's a wave that is going around Dominica, that wave for change. And I'll tell you, believe it or not, if you are not prepared to join with Jefferson James, Team Dominica, this wave will very well ride over you. So I'm urging you this evening, my brothers and sisters, lend your support to me, your incoming parliamentary representative. Lend your support to Team Dominica, the next government of Dominica. Lend your support to the Honorable Lennox Linton. Lend your support to yourselves, your families and friends as we move Dominica from better day to better day.